And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March Part 2, Blind. I am the RPG chick, now entering Whitestone Hollow. We have a quest or two and a couple bounties that we have to collect. So, entree. Yep, new map discovered. This is a new zone. Doesn't look like that much of a big one. We've already got this much uncovered just by standing here. But let's see what there is to be seen. Last few episodes we helped. Let's sneak.
Eyes open.
Yes. Closing them would not be a good idea.
No problem.
We helped the people at Durgan's Battery. Fixed our cannon, or rather, we completely did it for them. Whitestone Lake. We got more XP for discovering that. Interesting. Oh, wow. It is a big lake, and that's it. Let's go off the beaten trail and head, well, northeast-ish. Like I said, we do have bounties to fulfill here, so we're bound to get into pretty big fights. No discoverable things yet. Ah! Here's a young Skulldrak. Let's switch to range weapons. And that's a different kind of look, isn't it? Almost looks like we have a lightsaber. Attack. Oh, how about attack that first?
Let's try that.
Try it again. How about try something else? These, at least some of these, range weapons are not magical, so that's probably why they don't work. All the usual. Punching. Knocking down. This always looked like a Medusa head, but I realize it's... These are the legs, and that's the arms and the person's head, and they're going, whoa, man! Guy knocked me right down! Concussive missiles. And let's scare the hell out of them. That's everybody.
Yeah.
All right, Durance, blessing. I still love the old standbys, fireball. Actually surprised they didn't try calling it something else. Like, you know, magic missile is now concussive missile and such. Yeah, just kill that thing. Let's do the barbaric shout. Actually, let's save it. Because I only have one left, so do the barbaric yell. Boom. Well, this thing's almost dead, right?
I
Okay, if you're right there, hit that. Can you hit through that? I hope he can reach. No, he couldn't, but now he's okay. Alright, let's do with him. More concussive missiles. Oh, that thing's almost done. Oh! Relay that order. Hit that instead. Oh, instead he... Don't run up. Here. Oh, they're almost... Everyone's almost dead. Oh, he got his hit in, I think. Nice, all the chunks. Oh, there's more! That I did not even notice. Oh, you're gonna get it now. Cool. I don't know, I'm getting tired of fighting Skulldrax. Hope we can come across something else, you know. Even a wolf or something would be cool.
Quickly and quietly.
See. Alright. We've already uncovered a good deal of... Oh, there's a cave in there. Okay. We'll go there last. Or at least after we explore the outside environs. Oh, a bridge of sorts. That kind of looks like something we could go in as well, but I guess not. Interesting. Hope the bridge doesn't give way or something dramatic like that. That would be interesting. Oh, there's something here. And there's something there. Oh! A frost ooze. One down. Oh, I'm just gonna attack him, pretty much. Custom missile on that one. I like doing the holy radiance bit. Oh, we also got some kind of scarab or young ice beetle here. We can knock the... Oh, that's a beetle. That's why we can knock it over. How about a pillar of faith? Boom. More fireballs. Is she stuck? Oh, she's stuck, but she's just not attacking. I don't know if we can do wounding shot if that applies here.
Hey.
Clear out. Like the earth is shaking with the battle. We're just that strong, man. Alright, we got Svef, Ooze Plasma, Beetle shells, and wow. They had copper stuck in their carapaces. Or in their ooze, whatever. So, what is this? Tin hat. Pretty sure we've seen those before. This crude arrangement of antlers, bones, and sticks exudes a strong, fishy odor. Fishy odor.
Oh, and if I find something good, you can have half.
Oh, why, thank you. And in here, a +5 sword of awesomeness. With a suspense build now? Nope. A Werthonig. Huh. Werthonig? +3 to will, +15 to defense against frightened, terrified attacks for 300 seconds. Pretty cool. A weak form of mead, Werthonig is found only in Red Saris or on Red Sarins when they travel. Due to Red Saris' strict laws about intoxicants, Werthonig has relatively low alcohol content. Priests of Aethys regularly visit distilleries to ensure they are following the letter of the law. I don't know what I was trying to say frequently, but it is common for well-traveled Red Sarins to spike their supply when they travel to neighboring countries. Okay, so we have Red Sarins around. This is a clue, obviously. And a scroll of Hailstorm. Pretty sure we have Hailstorm already. Yeah, here. We don't even use these scrolls. Maybe in here is the +5 sort of awesomeness. Nope, we got some speckleback jerky. We'll take it, why the hell not? Alright.
Got it.
Got it. Cool. We'll check. Oh, we got some more of this tin hat stuff. Take a look out on the pier. And we see water. Very cold water. Let's go down south. The end of the map already. Ooh, someone's house? Who the hell lives out here? Haddi's house. The shallow reserves of water in this trough had frozen over. That's not surprising. Haddi is the one... And task then. Travel to Haddi's house. A stalwart villager by the name of Kern managed to inadvertently hire a bleak walker paladin to resolve a long-standing feud. The matter has now escalated beyond his control. Alright, so that's this. Let's check out the outside first. There's not much to check out. Briss? And Costa. Maybe we ought to go in and see. Go on then. They've seen us, they're just not... Boo! Costa says it's bad. This bad day's coming, I'm telling you. The pair look up at you as you approach. Who's the... Oh. Begging your pardon, lady. The villager shuffles to face you. Need any help? Don't think anybody could help Haddi now. It might not be too late, Casa says. Look, we saw some suspicious people leaving Hattie's house. They'd already torched the barn. Why are you standing out here, then? We were worried there might be one of them still inside. We're goat herds, not warriors. Suspicious people, huh? Not just looters, I mean. They were armored up like they were in for battle. And mean-looking. Briss says, Kern's got something to do with it. I just know it. I think I know what's going on. Briss says, can guess. I bet. We get a lot of bandits up here. It's just a shame it happened to Haddi. Costa says, still don't think it's bandits. But hey, have a look and you'll know for certain. Yes, what do you want? What happened here? We noticed some of Hattie's goats wandering loose. When we came up here, we saw some suspicious people leaving Haddi's house. Looks like they torched the barn. All right.
My eyes are peeled.
Let's continue scoping out the perimeter. It's always a good idea to scope out the perimeter. Even though there are people here. What's in here? Fish. We do not need the fish. Alright, well, before we uncover more of that, I guess we'll just go in the house. Be cautious. Be constant.
Quickly and quietly.
Oh my. Haddi and his wife have been killed. The Bleak Walker is nowhere to be seen. There may be hints within the house as to where they've gone. Yep, and that would be the most powerful one of them. All kinds of goodies in here. Push of displaced image. Camping supply, which you can't take out because we're full. A bloody thumbprint marks where someone pulled away a piece of bread. .22 stalwart bony. Someone has torn away several pages, leaving bloody smears behind. I don't know why I'm still sneaking. The fire has died down to a handful of glowing embers. Oh. Besides greens, we have a Durgan copper bracelet. Though Durgan's battery is mostly known for its steel, the refineries also produced extremely high-quality copper that was used in coinage, art, and jewelry. This copper bracelet is typical of the jewelry that was produced in the community at its height. Oh, I'll take that to sell somewhere. These guys can't use it anymore. Alright, well, I was saving that for last. The dead man's sprawled position gives you a clear view of the sword wound in his back. The smear drying blood around him has not yet faded to brown. Read his soul. You hear a groan, low and pained, and turn your head to see. There's a dull pain in your skull, and your vision swims. A harsh grip on your arm bears you upright on your knees. Elwina says, we don't have anything worth stealing. Elwina's voice cuts through your sluggish thoughts. You look up at the armored man seated at the table, your stomach knotting up with dread. Sylvestin says, no, you don't. He reaches almost idly for the ledger. You notice before he does the way that Elwina tenses up, but you're not sure why he opens the book and the letter falls out. You're not sure why until he opens the book and a letter falls out. Family? The man smiles as he picks up the letter. Elwina cries, no! She tries to run forward, only to get caught by the arm of the man behind her. Sylvestin says, looks like Eska's doing well at the mill. Sweet of him to write. Dyrford's a long way from here. The Bleak Walker Paladin says, enough, Sylvestin. All right, all right. He tosses the letter on the table, cruel amusement swiftly replaced with irritation. Kill him, Sylvestin says. You barely have time to register the words. The sword through your back drives the air from your lungs and the strength from your limbs all at once. Elwina's screams seem so faint. You have to get to her. You have to warn Eska somehow. but your legs won't listen. You can't breathe. The memory slips from you like a shucked coat, and the pain in your back fades just as quickly. By reading Haddi's soul, I learn of the circumstances leading to his death. The trio behind the killing are intent on tracking down Haddi's son Eska at the mill in Dyrford and finishing the job. Dyrford. Well. Dyrford, I can't say that right. Dyrford is off on the mainland, right? Dyrford village. Oh my God, I can't say that. Or crossing. Dyrford. I don't know, we're not going there yet. Probably after we finish this this zone. Now, can we talk to these guys again? Hattie's dead. Knew it had to be bad. Thanks for letting us know, stranger. Back here. Well, I want to follow them. I don't think I've ever been able to follow people before. Oh, they're going to hang out over here by the barn. The world's going up in flames, I swear it. And he swears it as well. Embers still smolder in these blackened ruins.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Sometimes it does, yes. Finger berries. We have a long reach. I guess we technically can't walk there, but we can pick berries there. There's a cart or something found. Something over there.
This I haven't seen before.
Apart from a few flecks of soot, the supplies in this cart are untouched. However, we cannot take any of them. This is why I sneak everywhere, guys, so we can find hidden stuff like this. Ring of Unshackling. Grants suppress affliction. 2 per rest. Nice. I think I've had a couple of these. And a scroll of Wall of Flame. We have Wall of Flame there. Ring of Unshackling. Oh, she actually has it now, Palagina. Okay, cool. That's why it seemed familiar. Any more secrets? Burn down house. We need to look all around here, though. We will travel west. And here! Our +5 Sword of Awesomeness! For some reason I had to walk that way to open it. Silver Loosh. Scroll of Flame Shield. I really don't use that. Oh. This mound is something of interest. Oh. Oh, here's a Greater Ice Blight. Okay. We'll check out the mound later. Oh my. The Terror of Whitestone Hollow. Oh, We're in trouble.
That's not very helpful.
Alright. Oh, what we got? Oh, those freaking Shangri-La things. I hate those. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. Die. Fireball. There. Now, I don't even know if these things have minds. I'm gonna have her do nothing for a second, because I'm gonna have her use try to use disintegration on that thing. So she's just gonna stay where she is for a minute. And I'm pretty sure, yeah, everyone else is acting.
I'm ready.
Adair, you can just hit that thing and try to knock it down at the same time. Oh, we got fun going on. I wonder if I can take over the mind of one of these Shangri-La things. They have minds, right? Ringleader. Try it. Blessing. Killing Bolt. Boom. Let me guess, she couldn't get this off yet, could she? She's still working on it. Killing Bolt on that, I'm sure it's tough. It's attacking, isn't it? Shangri-La raises greater earth blight. Nice. Cool. Yes, fight alongside me. Armor of Faith. We can reach everybody, good. Am I also casting on the thing, on the Shangri-La that's gonna be harder to kill? I am not sure. Oh, he's still casting that. Cool. Oh wait, that's... He can join in the fight too. Why the hell not?
And?
Never mind. Hit this thing. Killing Bolt again on that. And a Pillar of Faith, why not? Yeah, we're gonna have to hurt you now. Remember when those things were so hard? They were impossible for us to fight just one of them.
How may I help?
You can help by getting all these goodies. Ooh, Caravan Master's brooch. The brooch of Caravan Master Safehall that you found frozen in the center of the Terror of Whitestone Hollow. It was in there, man. Alright, Spirit Residue, Primal Wind, Primal Water, Primal Rock. Done. Bounty. I've eradicated Terror of Whitestone Hollow. Asuka will give me a reward in exchange for the brooch. Nice. Whistling in the Reeds completed. Kind of returns with 1689 experience. Cool. Anyway. Let's go back to sneaking mode.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
This pale, rough stone doesn't resemble any other formation in the area. Avalanche sight, huh? Let's check out the avalanche sight. Oh, there's something over here. Ringer berries. Oh. Yep. A lot of stuff was buried in snow. What we got here? Where do we have to go to get that? Huh. Vitro's formal footwear. +3 lore grants carouse. Where the hell that is. 1 per encounter and +4 dexterity. Carouse. Fill quick items with spirits. Spirits. Alright. Interesting. According to old Valian folk tales, Vitro was a young tailor from a poor village who dreamed of attending the Magiaverno ball at the Imperial Palace. However, though he had many fine clothes for himself, he had no shoes to match, no invitation from the Imperial family, and no knowledge of palace matters. One day, a kindly wizard heard his wish and gifted him with an enchanted pair of shoes. They were formal enough for the ball, and the wizard promised that they would provide all Vitro needed in time. Vitro took the wizard at his word and arrived at the palace gates the day of the ball, dressed in his best clothes and his new shoes. The guards on duty demanded Vitro's invitation, and suddenly the young man felt a weight in his pocket. He found a flask of fine spirits, which he gave the guards in exchange for entry. Continuing to the ball, he found himself in conversation with several vicomtes and marchesos. Vitro was certain his ignorance would betray him, but he spoke with such knowledge of history and custom that his hosts were impressed. His confidence in the wizard's shoes grew, and when he saw the most beautiful woman at the ball, he asked her to dance. The shoes guided his feet and his tongue, and such was his charm that he and the young princessa were wed by the year's end. A happy ending. You know, so many of these things have, like, you know, the shoes fell off, and then she, like, looked at him in disgust, and he never saw her again. That's the average description, or ending of a description in Pillars of Eternity. There's always, like, some kind of twist to it. So, what do... That could be handy, somehow. If we need a lot of lore for something, to get past something. And what about this? Gotta walk all the way around it. The glyphs seem similar to those seen in the battery, but they're too worn to make out. Oh, there's a goodie over there as well.
still don't see why...
What?
We had to hurt the dogs.
Shut it about the blazing dogs!
Okay, that was not us. And that was not the ice plant.
Let's go!